Hassan, thank you. And as we mentioned right off the top here, the governor's race is all set now. Democrat Maggie Hassan against Republican Ovide Lamontagne.
And get this, both candidates joining us live in the studio this morning. We do want to start with Maggie Hassan. First of all, thank you for waking up with us. I know it's been a long night for you.
Well, it sure has, but a good night, and we're very excited about the work ahead and moving the state forward.
Talk about your reaction, first of all, to the results last night. Any surprises?
Well, it just was very gratifying. You know, you work so hard in a campaign. There are so many volunteers and people working just to make sure that we got our message out and communicated with voters about what's at stake in this election. And so it's great to have all of that work come together and pay off.
Now, you have experience up in Concord. How do you think that's going to set you apart from your opponent?
Well, I have a real record of common sense problem solving to find solutions that help the people of New Hampshire. We need to focus on jobs and the economy. The best way to do that is to make sure that we're helping our businesses grow and create jobs, have the best workforce in the nation, which means, of course, working with our educators to make sure that our education system is a good match for 21st century business needs. And I have a real proven record of that kind of accomplishment and problem solving in the state Senate.
What do you make of the criticism by your opponent of being too liberal, of wanting to put government in charge?
Well, you know, I worked very closely with John Lynch while I was in the state Senate for 6 years, and we have a record of very practical problem solving. So whether it was standing up to insurance companies that were discriminating against sick workers, which I did in my very first term, or co-sponsoring the research and development tax credit to help businesses come to New Hampshire and create products that will really help our economy grow, or whether it was the job training program that we created with Governor Lynch that's trained 14,000 workers, or the New Hampshire Working Program, which really helped businesses and workers fight the economy together. I think that shows a kind of forward-thinking problem solving that brings the people of New Hampshire together to find ways to meet our challenges together moving forward.
I know that you've already gotten the endorsement of President Clinton. Will we be seeing him in New Hampshire stumping for you?
Well, President Clinton is in very high demand these days. I'm thrilled with his endorsement because, of course, during his time as president, he really created jobs, our economy grew, and that's what I want to do too.
All right, Maggie Hassan, the Democratic nominee, congratulations on your win last night, and thank you for waking up with us this morning.
Well, thank you for having me.
Sure. Taking another look at the actual numbers from the gubernatorial races last night, Maggie Hassan held off a late charge from Jackie Silley. This is with 92% of precincts reporting, 54% for Hassan, 39% for Jackie Silley, and 7% for Bill Kennedy, finishing it in third.
Yeah, and on the Republican side, Ovide Lamontagne took two-thirds of the vote, easily defeating Kevin Smith. And Ovid joins us. He's in our studio this morning to talk about his win and the campaign moving forward. First off, congratulations and thanks for joining us this morning.
Well, it's great to be with you. I'm not on my treadmill like I usually am when I'm with you early in the morning.
Oh, but, you're one of those that are exercising while they watch us. You know, you've been in this spot before. You've been the nominee before. Do you think this is your time?
Well, I think that this is the time for a leader, a conservative leader who's tested, proven, and principled and has a focus on job creation and the economy. I have the experience, the vision, and the plan to move New Hampshire forward. I'm a much different candidate than I was 16 years ago, and I'm looking forward to the general election, a very important election here in New Hampshire. And it's going to be a stark choice between one view versus, I think, a prosperity agenda that we can bring that'll be very successful to New Hampshire.
Now, some have said the Republican Party's a little bit fractured right now. Do you think that they'll coalesce around you for the general election?
I think the vote turnout yesterday and the totals we received shows that there's really a mandate that I be the nominee. Kevin Smith was very generous in calling me. I invited him immediately to our team, and he said, absolutely, yes, we're going to start working today. Unity breakfast is tomorrow morning. And I really think that our party's going to be not more than just unified. We're going to be bringing in independents and Democrats into our cause, and it's going to be a very exciting race.
You're a business attorney, and you and your challenger are talking a lot about job creation, but can you get specific about what specifically you would do to create jobs in the state of New Hampshire?
Well, first of all, unlike my opponent, I don't believe government creates jobs. The private sector creates jobs. Government needs to get out of the way of job creation, which is why the first day On day one, I'll appoint a business advocate to the governor's office, working with a business advisory group to troubleshoot for businesses, cut through the red tape. Secondly, I'll impose a moratorium on any new rules and regulations and require an economic impact analysis for those. And third, we're going to have a statewide economic development plan, something we don't have today. And we're going to focus on helping businesses succeed in their areas within our state. And we're going to brand New Hampshire and rename our marketing department from dread to something else. This change is coming in Concord, and I think people are ready for it.
All right, Ovide Lamontagne, the Republican nominee. Congratulations.
Thank you, Sean. Thank you, Aaron.